Let's get to this this COVID team hearing, one of the first we've heard from the White House. Take a listen.
Sharing continued actions that the public can take to protect themselves and their loved ones. Let's start with an overview of the data. There are some hopeful signs that we are watching very closely. 25.1 million COVID-19 cases have been reported to the CDC through January 25th. During the week of January 19th through the 25th, the seven-day average of new cases decreased by 21% to over 166,000 per day. During the week of January 18th to 24th, the seven-day average of new hospital admissions of patients with COVID-19 also decreased by 15% to nearly 13,000 per day. However, over 78,000 patients were hospitalized with COVID-19 as of January 24th. 419,827 deaths have been reported since January 22nd, 2020. During the week of January 19th to January 25th, the seven-day average number of deaths decreased by 4.9% to 3,113 per day. And while these data are trending downward is a good sign, the number during the outbreak was reported on January 20th, the peak number of 4,383 deaths. Though I am encouraged by these trends, our case rates remain extraordinarily high, and now is the time to remain vigilant. If we continue on the current trajectory, the CDC predicts that 479,000 to 514,000 COVID-19 deaths will be reported by February 20th, 2021. I know this is not news we all want to hear, but this is something we must say so we are all aware. But if we are united in action, we can turn things around. Continuing to expand safe, effective vaccination is key to ending the COVID-19 pandemic and bringing our country back to health. Daily vaccine doses administered.
You are listening to the Biden White House COVID response team, their first press briefing, talking about some of the hopefully positive signs on new cases, hospitalizations, and COVID deaths.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.